So, Kumar Shubham.
Yes, sir.
Would you please introduce yourself to the board members?
Yes, sir. So, my name is Kumar Shubham.
Yeah.
So, I come from Jamshedpur in Jharkhand. So, I did my basic schooling from Jamshedpur itself, up to class 10. Sir, after that, I did my graduation from IIT Roorkee. So, I was enrolled in the integrated dual degree program. That is an integrated 5-year course with BTech in Metallurgical Materials Engineering and MTech in Materials Engineering. So, thereafter, sir, I have been pursuing civil services. So, I'm preparing for civil services.
So, you are preparing for civil service. You are basically from Jharkhand.
Yes,
Jharkhand. So, when this Jharkhand was separated from Bihar?
So, on 15th of November 2000.
15th of November 2000.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me the amendments through which it was separated? Which amendment act?
Sorry, sir, I'm not able to recollect at the moment.
Can't recall. Okay, what is the process for the amendment?
So, to create a new state, sir, amendment has to be brought in under Article 3 of the Constitution. Sir, first of all, the president, before recommending any bill, state reorganization bill, has to recommend, has to ask the states on for which the creation is to be done, the legislative of that state, for its views. So after that, it has the recommendation of the state is to be given in a particular period of time. So for instance, it is 14 days, and sir, after that, the matter is taken for voting in the parliament, and it has to be passed by simple majority. It is not an amendment under Article 368. And sir, if passed, the state gets separated or formed.
Well, so see, the recommendation of the state legislature,
yes,
is it binding or not?
No, sir, it is not binding.
It's just a consensus.
Yes, sir, it is just a consultation.
Okay. And what is the process under Article 368?
So, Article 368 is the process of amending the constitution by special majority. So, it has two divisions. So, one part of the amendment in the 368 entails special majority of the parliament. So, it is only with the parliament only. Only parliament has to ratify. So, it is to be passed by special majority. That is, so 2/3 of the member present and voting, and a majority of the total membership of the house. And sir, those matters which deal with the federal provisions, such as election of president, or matters of right in which the states are also involved. Sir, in that we have to take the ratification of at least half of the state legislatures.
If there is disagreement between the two houses, what is the provision?
So there is no provision for joint sitting in these cases in Article 368. So constitutional amendment bill does not provide for a system mechanism for joint sitting. So the bill gets elapsed. So
the bill gets elapsed. Okay, very good. And why this 97th Amendment Act that was struck down by the Supreme Court? Because some provisions of this act was struck down by the Supreme Court. So, what was the problem in this act?
So, 97th Constitutional Amendment Act talked about cooperative societies.
Okay.
So, it had certain provisions related with the rights of the states. So, which was not in repugnance with the provisions of the Constitution. And henceforth, sir, a part of it is struck down. However, sir, the entirety of the act which provides for cooperative societies is still valid and it's still a part of the constitution.
So only you want to say that only that part which is affecting the federal structure.
Yes, sir.
That was struck down.
Yes, sir.
Okay. After the bifurcation of,
yes,
Bihar and Jharkhand, what do you think? Do you think that it has benefited Jharkhand, but it proved harmful to the Bihar?
Sir, I think that definitely it has benefited Jharkhand. Sir, Jharkhand has been seeing a double digit growth rate. Sir, for instance, in 2018, sir, it was around 10.22%. And sir, other centers of economic activities have also, other towns of economic activities or engines of growth have emerged, such as sir, Deoghar or Bokaro or Jamshedpur. So these have emerged. So, similarly, sir, there have been work on connectivity aspects. Sir, Sahibganj has been developed as a multimodal transportation hub. Similarly, sir, a new airport has been inaugurated in 2018 by our sir, Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Deoghar. Sir, on the issue of Bihar, sir, I would say that it has not suffered as much. Sir, there is, definitely, sir, it has lost a lot of mineral resources that was there in Jharkhand. However, sir, Bihar too has been witnessing a double-digit growth rate. Sir, in fact, it is the fastest growing state in India for the past, if we neglect the present slowdown and the present recession that the country economy is seeing. So before that, Bihar was seeing a growth rate, compound annual growth rate of around 13.47% between 2012 and 2017. So sir, that had been impressive. But sir, there are issues. There are still development challenges in both Bihar and Jharkhand that we need to work upon.
Can you tell me there are the two rivers that originates in Jharkhand and meets River Ganga in Bihar? It originates in Jharkhand and meets River Ganga in Bihar.
Sorry, sir, I'm not able to think at the moment.
Can you tell me two common tribes of Bihar and
Jharkhand? Sir, common?
Common tribes.
Sir, common tribes in Bihar, Jharkhand are, sir, Orao, Munda, Santhal. So these are some of the tribes.
Orao, Munda and Santhal.
Yes, sir.
So, can you tell me any speciality about these tribes or any one tribe?
Sir,
some tribes have some special features. So, can you tell me the special features of any one, Orao, Munda or Santhal?
So Munda has Munda tribe has been a very important part of the Jharkhand. So there is a tribal leader, Sir Shri Birsa Munda. So he was a freedom fighter, and he had led the tribal revolt against the British. So he is very famous for that.
He is also worshipped.
Yes, sir. He is
worshipped. What is the god?
So Birsa Munda god.
Birsa Munda. But there is another term, the tribal term for this also.
Sorry, sir, I'm not.
No, not. So, what was his teaching? Because he is worshipped as a god, or he is a prophet for the Krishna tribe. So, there must have been some teachings of this. Can you tell me one, two, or three teachings?
So, first of all, more than a tribal leader and a revolter against the British, sir, he was revered as a god because he was a social reformer. So he had talked about removing the distinction between the society that was existing in the society, the forceful conversions that the people of the tribes of Munda were seeing, sir, that conversion to Christianity. So he was against it. So these were some of the prominent roles that he played in Jharkhand. He was a social reform basically. So he was worshipped as a god. So he was not. So he did not only fought against the British, but he worked in several other areas as well. And so that too at a very young age. Okay. That was a very remarkable thing. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Shubham, what I would like to know from you is the role of the youth in a development of country. India is a young country,
yes,
right? Full of young age population. So, what do you think is the role of youth in our country?
So, first of all, sir, it is said that, Bihar government, sir, in the Saat Nishchay program has said that, sir, Yuva Shakti is Bihar ki Pragati. So it emphasizes the importance of youth in the development of any state or any region or in a or in the country as a whole. So first of all, sir, if we have younger population, sir, it creates a demographic potential for the country. Sir, they can be employed in various economic activities. Sir, they can be trained to reap in the employment opportunities that generate. Moreover, sir, they can be driver for growth in the country. So they can be involved in startups or entrepreneurship, thereby creating more and more opportunities. Similarly, sir, they can bring about social change, sir, social entrepreneurship, like an academy is there. So the magnitude of change that the youth can bring is unimaginable, and sir, henceforth our policy making is also focused on tapping that potential.
So, after looking at your CV, I don't find as eligible youth who contributes in development of India as you.
Thank you.
Right? What your CV also suggests is right from 2017 when you passed this integrated graduation course, from 2017 to 2021 you were playing only mobile e-sports. Have you wasted yourself? Has this country wasted a resource?
Sir, I would not say that my country has wasted a resource. So I believe I have studied a lot during this period. So I have gained a lot of knowledge on various aspects of our country, our international issues. So I believe that I can any day apply these knowledge. So basically, my personality has developed each day. So every day that I have seen over the years, so over the 4 years, so I have learned something new that I believe I can contribute to the society when I become an appropriate platform, sir.
But 4 years, four or five years of this duration, you could have earned you would have helped a company earn, and both of you would have paid tax, they would have paid corporate tax, you would have paid income tax, which country has lost. What you have to say on that? And like you, there are many youth who are just unemployed because of this adamance to secure a government job. Why do you think is this happening in our country?
So first of all, sir, there are various advantages of being in a government job. So the career growth prospect is very good. So first, so secondly, there is a good security of tenure, so in this. So thirdly, the perks and facilities that come with and the social prestige that comes with a government job, sir, is unmatchable. And sir, we cannot compare it with any private job. Sir, on the issue of sir, I not being contributing to the corporate world by getting a job, this, sir, I believe that, sir, this is a competitive examination, sir. I believe, like me, like myself, sir, there are many students who have been writing the exam, and sir, it is a competitive exam, sir. Sir, several of them pass, and sir, others try the next year. Sir, I happen to be in the latter lot. Sir, nevertheless, sir, I believe I have gained enough knowledge that I will be able to contribute to the society if I have given the appropriate platform, sir.
Okay. So as per you, this Nandan Nilekani or Ravish Kumar or anyone who is employed in private sector are, you know, not that much socially prestigious as much as the government officials. You think so?
Absolutely not, sir. Sir, it was more of a personal choice that I wanted to be in a bureaucracy. So I believe, sir, I have said that, sir, I believe that, sir, there is role of each and every individual in the society. Sir, doctors are there, journalists are there, sir, technocrats are there. So everyone has some or the other role. So even at the ground level, sir, the carpenters or the sir, laborers, sir, everyone has their role some or the other way in the society, and they contribute to the development and upliftment. And even the bureaucrats, sir, so they ensure that policy are made in such a way that we are able to tap the potential of each and every persons in the that are present in the society.
Shubham, you have secured this department gold medal.
Yes, sir.
So congratulations on that. What role do you think it plays in a student's life, in an individual's life?
Sir, first of all, sir, it gives a lot of confidence to pursue. Sir, it was one of the reasons where, sir, I did not set for placement, sir, because I had a good CGPA in my department. So that gave me the confidence that I had a backup plan with me whenever I prepared for civil services. So that helped me take a calculated risk. So more than this, sir, I believe this shows the sincerity that I have given to a particular thing. So whatever I have taken, and the same sincerity, sir, and the same hard work, sir, I feel that I will be able to bring it to the service sector, civil service sector as well.
So, having earned this department gold medal, why, and you have taken this physics as an optional subject, so why didn't you go for a physics Olympiad and win gold for the country? The country would have felt the same way that you felt after winning this department gold medal.
Sir, the department gold medal that I've got is in metallurgy and materials. So we actually don't have any Olympiad for that. But on the physics front, sir, I believe Olympiad is something that is of very high competition level, much more competitive than the sir, gate examination. So I think, sir, I might not have stood a chance over there. Sir, I did try. Sir, I was not able to clear the national level. So, sir, that was the main reason, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Shubham. Yes, sir.
There again, who was the winner for Nobel for physics last year?
Sir, last year.
The latest one.
The latest one.
Announced in 2020.
Yes, sir. Dr. Roger Penrose, sir, got the Nobel Prize for the detection of, basically he discovered that the formation of black holes is a prediction of the general theory of relativity. And sir, secondly, two scientists, sir, Dr. Sir Reinhard Genzel and Dr. Andrea Ghez, just jointly got the Nobel Prize for detection of a supermassive compact object at the center of our galaxy.
Okay, and who was the first recipient of Nobel Prize?
Sir, it was in 1901, but sir, I am not able to currently guess the name, sir. Sorry, sir.
And how does the whole movement of Nobel began?
Sorry, sir, I'll read more on this.
Who invented X-rays?
Sir, actually, Dr. Bragg, D. Bragg, had studied a lot on it, but sir, I don't know exactly know who who was actually responsible for inventing X-rays?
Okay, what is Mach number?
So Mach number is basically to measure the speed of any object related to speed of sound. So 1 Mach is basically the velocity of sound in air, that is 330 meter per second. And sir, comparing that, sir, we can have various velocities such as subsonic velocity, which is less than 0.8 Mach, or sir, near sonic, that is 0.8 to 1.2 Mach, or supersonic 1.2 to 5 Mach, and hypersonic, that is above 5 Mach.
Hypersonic is?
Above 5 Mach.
Above 5
Mach. Yes, sir.
Okay. What are rare earth elements?
Sir, rare earth elements are the 17 17 chemically related element groups, such as lanthanum, europium, neodymium, which are found very rarely on the surface of Earth. So these may some of these are actually found in very large quantities. However, we don't have a sufficient amount of technology, or the economic. So economics is not such good that we can extract it in a commercial scale. Sir, mostly China has a monopoly of rare earth metals at the moment.
And what is the importance of rare earth elements in modern economics?
So first of all, sir, it is said that the electronics industry would collapse if we do not have the rare earth metals. So if we talk about neodymium, sir, it is used as a vibrating mechanism in mobile phones. Similarly, sir, the radar mechanisms of the defense. So uses neodymium. Similarly, europium is used in lithium-ion batteries. So there are numerous applications of basically the rare earth materials in the present scenario in electronics industry.
So often nowadays we are saying that each and every part of our life are depending now on microchips.
Yes, sir.
What is microchips? Why it is called so?
So microchips is basically an electronic chip that is in which the components of it are manufactured at a very small level, on a very small scale, that is of the order of micrometers, that is basically 10 to the minus 6 meters. So if we are having smaller and smaller size of electronics that are embedded in these chips, so we can create some electronics in such a way that, first of all, they use lot less amount of materials. So secondly, the sizes of the materials go on decreasing. So for instance, we see the mobile phones. It has got more and more advanced, so it has got more and more features by keeping the size almost same over the years. So this is the thing about microchips.
Is there any role of a semiconductor in a microchip?
So actually, all the electronic components are based on semiconductor chips only. So first of all, there is a semiconductor, plate on which semiconductor chips are embedded. So that chip is also made of semiconductors. So then there are silicon-based electronic materials that are used in these chips, such as BJT or FET. So these are basically the components of the microchips.
And which kind of circuit are there on a microchip?
Sorry, sir, I'm not getting the question.
What is an IC?
Sir, integrated. Sorry, sir, I'm not able to get the name of this IC. Integrated.
So is IC circuit? Is what we found on the microchips?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you heard about geothermal energy? What is it?
So geothermal energy is basically the energy that is a renewable energy that we can get from the the heat of from the Earth's crust or below the Earth's surface. So for instance, we can tap the energy from geospring or hot springs, or from geysers, or similarly from the energy that can be tapped from the crustal movement, the friction that is created, the heat that is generated, so if we can tap that, that is a very good source of renewable energy.
Any more source
of renewable energy?
Of geothermal energy, sir.
I think that volcanoes are also a very good source of geothermal energy. So wherever tectonic activities are there, sir, we can tap the geothermal energy, such as
tectonic activities. Yes, and what is that belt known as?
It's a seismic belt, seismic zone.
What are orogenic belts?
Orogenic belts are the belts that are useful in the creation of continents. Sir, I'm not very sure.
Okay. Have you heard about World Heritage Sites?
Yes, sir.
How many World Heritage Sites are there in India?
So India has currently 40 World Heritage Sites. So recently two have been added.
Who are they?
First is, 39th site is the Rudrappa Temple or the Rudreshwar Temple in Telangana. And the 40th site is the historic or the archaeological city of Dholavira.
Dholavira is?
Gujarat.
Gujarat. What's the importance of Dholavira?
So Dholavira is the fifth largest Harappan site that has been excavated. So it has been a part of the later Harappan period in which various discoveries have been found, and various notable excavations have been found. So the town planning, it had also special features that it was divided into three parts of the city. Most of the Harappan cities were basically divided into two parts. So one was Citadel on the west and the lower town on the east. But sir, Dholavira is the only city in Harappa that has been divided into three parts.
Okay, and what's the importance of that temple, Ramappa Temple? What's unique about that?
Sir, it is a Lord Shiva temple. I am not very sure.
Built in which century?
Sorry, sir, I'll read more on this.
Are there any World Heritage Sites in Bihar?
Yes, sir. So there are two World Heritage Sites. So one is the archaeological remains of Nalanda Mahavihar, and the second is the Mahabodhi Temple Complex in Gaya.
Okay, and who awards this WHS site's designation?
Sir, there is a committee which is known as the UNESCO World Heritage Committee, which decides the sites, which designates the sites.
Okay, Kumar Shubham,
yes,
your interview is over.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, thank you. And
thank you, sir.
I will give you feedback right now. Shubham, frankly speaking, I am very impressed with your interview. You can say it's very impressive.
Thank
you, sir. And this way, you will be very good. And I think you have that caliber and you have the knowledge, and you can go for UPSC also.
So, I have the interview.
Your interviews may be chal raha.
Yes,
that. यहाँ पे एक चीज आपको कंट्रोल करना पड़ेगा, जस्ट वन थिंग. सो आई सी एन एलिमेंट ऑफ हर इन योर आंसर.
ओके सर,
ठीक है. इसको इसका दो कारण है, मैं बताता हूँ उसे दो कारण. फर्स्टली ये है कि जो बोर्ड मेंबर्स जो बैठे रहते हैं, तो दे आर ओवर एज अराउंड 55-60 होंगे. तो उनको थोड़ा चाहिए, एक गैप चाहिए उसको रिसीव करने के लिए.
ओके सर.
सेकेंडली क्या है कि कुछ ऐसे मेंबर्स होंगे जो कि दे आर नॉट वेरी मच कंफर्टेबल इन इंग्लिश.
ओके सर.
आप अगर थोड़ा सा गैप करोगे करोगे तो दे कैन आल्सो अंडरस्टैंड, बट इफ अगर इतना हरी में बोलोगे तो उन्हें लगेगा कि दे विल नॉट शो इंटरेस्ट इन योर आंसर.
ओके सर,
ठीक है. सो थोड़ा सा अगर ये जो एलिमेंट ऑफ जो हरी है उसको अगर थोड़ा सा डाउन करते हो तो ये ज्यादा इंटरेक्टिव होगा, और आई थिंक इट विल गेन अटेंशन ऑफ द बोर्ड मेंबर्स आल्सो.
ओके सर,
ठीक है. तो उसमें ज्यादा इंगेजिंग लगेगा.
ओके सर.
तो आप बस यही, मुझे लगता है बाकी नॉलेज फ्रंट पे कोई कमी नहीं है आपको, अच्छा है. एंड यू आर वेल अवेयर ऑफ ऑल दिस थिंग्स, सो बेस्ट ऑफ लक.
थैंक यू सर.
मुझे लगता है कि आप जो है सो टॉप 10 में हम लोग देख रहे हैं आपको, ठीक है, डेफिनेटली. एंड आप बीएससी करो और अच्छा है, बिकॉज जो आपने क्वालिफिकेशन जो गेन किया है, चाहे जो नॉलेज गेन किया है, आई डोंट थिंक दिस इज द प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर यू विल परफॉर्म.
ओके सर,
ठीक है.
ओके सर.
शुभम.
यस सर.
It was a very nice interview of yours today.
Thank you, sir.
I think when you entered the room,
yes, sir,
you had that feedback in mind. कि धीरे हो जाना है, धीरे जाना.
हाँ, थोड़ा
सा. In the beginning, you were okay.
Okay, sir.
In the beginning, but there was two times when that again came back in you.
Oh.
वो tough questions पे, जब आपसे कोई tough questions पूछा जा रहा था,
I'm nervous पे है सर.
Yes, you automatically raised your voice as well as increased the speed. One time.
Okay.
The next time is gradually when the interview came to an end, वो closure वाले period में आपने उस time पे उसको एकदम आपको एकदम ग्रेविटेटिव बनाना है, आपको पर्सनालिटी को बिल्कुल ग्रेविटेटिव. मुझे देख करके लगना चाहिए कि अगर इनको मैंने डीएम ऑफ पटना बनाया, किसी उम्र में ये उस चीज को हैंडल कर लेंगे, चाहे कोई भी बड़ी बड़ी समस्या है ना, एकदम आपकी पर्सनैलिटी में वो दिखना चाहिए. टुडे आई वॉज हैप्पी विद योर इंटरव्यू. आई वॉन्ट दैट, वेरी नाइस. body language, very nice. Speed, I have already said. Saying no, the answer when you don't know anything,
okay,
saying no actually is an answer in an interview.
Okay.
We consider that as an answer, and so does the interview board members. So that you say in a very nice way.
Okay.
So, sorry, sir, I don't know the answer. I'll read more on this or something like that. So that is a place where you do nice, and you should be very frank about that.
Okay.
You should not hold. The negative thing, एक तो tough questions में आपके voice, civil servant और private jobs.
Okay.
वहाँ पे आपको realize हुआ था आपने गलती कर दी.
हाँ sir, उतना chance
नहीं है ना. वहाँ पे आपने सीधा आप जो private jobs कर रहे हो, उनको आपने एकदम demean कर दिया था. Prestige, आपको इस answer पे work करना पड़ेगा. Because आपका resume इतना अच्छा है कि आपसे मैं ये question पूछूंगा कि why are you coming here?
Yes sir.
वो वहाँ पे आपने जो जो points दिए वो गलत थे.
Okay.
चाहे social prestige की बात, चाहे और जो भी पॉइंट्स आपने वहां पे बोले थे वो सब रॉन्ग थे. यू हैव टू वर्क ऑन दिस आंसर. और प्राइवेट नेक्स्ट टाइम में जब मैंने काउंटर किया तो उस टाइम पे आपने प्राइवेट कारपेंटर्स तक चले गए और आपने बोला कि सबका कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन है, व्हिच इज राइट.
यस सर,
यू आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट. तो आपको वो चीज उसको करना है. एंड वन थिंग दैट आई विल से इज आप, आई होप कि आप हेयर कट कट ले
सर. मेरा टाइप हां संडे को
करा. हां, ये कूलनेस नहीं.
यस सर,
ग्रेविटी.
यस सर.
So that will be all from my side. Thank you so much. This was very nice. All the best.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you.
Shubham,
yes,
वही है.
Yes.
थोड़ा सा अभी speed पे control और करना है.
Yes, sir. Yes.
In that sense, if I'd say कि उस दिन अगर आप 80 के speed पे थे, तो आज आप 60-70 तक तो आए हैं.
Yes.
But it needs to be around 50.
Okay. Yes, sir.
ठीक है.
Yes.
तो मुझे लगता है आप जैसे background वाले इस language में ज़्यादा अच्छी तरह से grab करते हैं. डिजिटल मार्क मैथमेटिकल लैंग्वेज, ये आपको करना है. रेस्ट अवेयरनेस पार्ट आपका ठीक है. एक जगह थोड़ा सा मुझे डिसअपॉइंटमेंट हुआ, नोबेल्स.
मैं वो पढ़ लूंगा मैं ऐसा.
ठीक है, बिकॉज नोबेल्स का स्टार्टिंग ही फिजिकल कॉज से हुआ है एंड द फर्स्ट नोबेल विनर वाज आल्सो अ फिजिसिस्ट. दैट्स व्हाई आई आंसर्ड यू हु इन्वेंटेड एक्सरेस. और इसलिए विलियम रॉन्जन को मिला था.
साइंस में पढ़ा था, याद
है. 1900 का आपने बिल्कुल सही कहा सर. विलियम रॉन्जन को इसलिए मिला था. वही है जो स्पीड पार्ट है ना, जो ग्रेविटी पार्ट है वो दिखनी चाहिए. ओएक्यूज आप समझते हो? ओएक्यूज ऑफिसर्स लाइक क्वालिटी.
ओके,
तो ऑफिसर्स लाइक क्वालिटी आप में दिखनी चाहिए. और ग्रेविटी और उसमें एक है सिंसियरिटी, बिकॉज वो सिंसियरिटी शो करता है.
ओके सर.
और बस वही है, रेस्ट एवरीथिंग इज फाइन. We are hopeful. We are going to see you in 1 to 10.
Thank you.
But your ultimate aim should have to be either UPSC or your own staff.
Yes.
वहाँ पे UPSC में भी same चीज, same feedback पे आप काम करना. Hair cut लेकर भी जाना है, you have to look very nicely on this, these things.
Yes.
Gravity पे काम करो आप लोग. पूछना किसी से कि am I looking childish when I'm saying this? Am I look
haircut और मतलब tie वगैरह के साथ मतलब अच्छे से
हाँ 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 हाँ
हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हाँ हा